I hope you all are doing great. Let us start with a small and interesting activity. I would request you all to close your eyes and be silent for some moments. Okay. Now slowly open your eyes. Imagine if I asked you to do the same for the entire day. How will you feel? I'm sure that you will start feeling boring. Yes, because sound is very, very important. Communication is very important, as communication helps us to relate, to talk with our family and friends. As we see throughout the day, we get to hear different sounds. In the morning, we get to hear the chirping of beautiful birds. In the evening, the sound becomes more prominent. As we all go back home from our work, we find the children playing on the streets. So today, the poem that we are doing describes basically the sounds in the evening. So we are beginning with a very beautiful poem, Sounds in the Evening by Elena Ferjian. Elena Ferjian, she was not only a great poet, but she was also a very good author, as she wrote many stories based on children. She wrote biographies and also she wrote more about history. So, let us begin with the poem, Sounds in the Evening. The sounds in the evening go all through the house, the click of the clock and the tick of the mouse. The footsteps of people upon the top floor, the skirts of my mother that brush by the door. The click in the boards and the creak of the chairs, the fluttering murmurs outside the stairs. The ring of bells, the arrival of guests, the laughter of my father at one of his chests. The clashing of dishes as dinner goes in. The babble of voices that distance makes thin. The mewing of cat that seems just by my ear. The hooting of owls that can never seem near. The quiver little noises that no one explains. Till the moon through the slats of my window blind beams. And the world of my eyes and my ears fill with steam. And as I find my pillow, the world of my dream. So children, you can see that in this poem, we can see different sounds. And in the poem, the word which actually describes sounds are called as onomatopoetic words. Okay, so here we can see that the different sounds of the clock, then as we know, as we become dark, even the nocturnal creatures, they come out, okay? Like we have seen in this poem, right? There are three nocturnal creatures described, like the cat, the owl, and which one? Yes, which we have in this particular poem, that is also about the mouse, yes. So this is a very, very informative poem, it's describing about the sound.